was asked to talk a little bit just about broader things about Chevrolet and what we're doing specifically with Volt and some of our go-to-market strategies. So obviously I'll be available to have any specific discussions after the fact. But just a little bit just about Chevy. It's been a phenomenal year for us, and I work on cars and crossovers, performance electric, so I have a great privilege and honor to work on that. But more broadly for Chevy overall, when you include that portfolio as well as our truck portfolio, sales are up for us overall, but more importantly from a retail perspective and outpacing the industry. So we're picking up share. I think it's been 5 months now in a row that share has been up for us. We're exceeding our sales goals. And you can imagine what it's like at Chevrolet, because every hour, right? Because today's the close day, right? So the ticker is coming through every hour here. And the news is going to be, I think, very positive for us as we announce our sales results tomorrow. So the story is good overall from a Chevrolet perspective, from a sales standpoint. When you look at things like where we're drawing customers from, conquest numbers are up, our loyalty numbers are up, the retail share is up. So everything is firing at all cylinders. It really started a long time ago, really, with our introduction, as Kevin mentioned, our 5 and 15, and accelerating that effort. Really, at the New York Auto Show, we really began what we have our Shattering Perceptions campaign, a different voice for Chevrolet in the market. And so a combination of phenomenal product, we think, very smart marketing, great dealer partners, great product is really fueling a good story from us from a Chevrolet standpoint. You know, and when you look specifically at electrification, the story is very broad and it's very deep. And again, it began back with broadening the Spark EV portfolio, pushing that out into Maryland and other territories. The Volt reveal was the big story for us at NAS, as well as the Volt EV concept reveal, which was followed up very shortly after that at Chicago with the announcement of the production intent of that vehicle. And then the Malibu Hybrid just culminates the story and keeps building on the technology. And it really is a broad electrification portfolio and story that we can tell to our customers. And candidly gives our dealers, we think, a very competitive advantage in the marketplace, because it's not one solution, it's a number of solutions. And the technology and the development that's put into the vehicle you see today transcends and gets into other parts of our portfolio. So we're very excited about the vehicles that we'll have the privilege to bring to market, starting with Volt and then what comes in the future. You know, years ago when Volt Gen 1 was launched, and I had the privilege to work on that product on the outside, I was actually at the agency at that time, you know, it was a very different and new proposition. No customer base, no established market, and it was kind of like, what are we gonna do with this thing, right? And so the good fortune we have now is we think we're launching from a position of strength. 80,000 owners out there in the marketplace, the clearly most awarded vehicle since its introduction, you know, 700 million pure EV miles, millions of gallons of gas, excuse me, saved, all the statistics and things that really point to the tremendous success that we feel Volt Gen 1 has been. And it's not just the engineering and technology of this car, it's proven the marketplace when it comes to dependability and appeal. When you talk to Volt owners, they clearly love that vehicle and they love talking about it and they love being a part of the Volt community. And that's certainly something that we take advantage of and we're very appreciative of at Chevrolet. You know, it's appropriate that we're here in the San Francisco area because Volt does a number of things for us. It gives us a technology halo. It's a design statement. It's innovation. It is the ultimate expression of Find New Roads, which really is our go-to-market philosophy. It's more than a tagline. It's who we are as a company. And Volt, we think, really embodies that. And it brings new customers to the Chevrolet franchise. Volt is the number one selling passenger car in San Francisco. So if you ask the question about, you know, you think, well, is it Malibu, is it Cruise? But it's interesting that Chevrolet is able to come into a market with a product like this in a very difficult market for a brand like Chevrolet and make progress. And we're bringing the right sort of customers into the franchise. These are people with a very desirable demographic profile. You see them on the screen there. They're very different than the broad overall Chevrolet average, which has trucks and a number of other vehicles that make up that portfolio that you see there. When we turn specifically to the marketing, there's always a lot of questions that we get asked about Chevrolet. So I'm just trying to give you a little sense of kind of how we're going to go to market and what we're going to do with this vehicle. If I had to give you some headlines about it, I'd say the first headline is we're going to advertise Volt in 2015, and we're going to advertise Volt in in 2016. You know, one of the questions is, if you just advertise this car, then everything would be great. And that's part of the equation, but there's a lot of things that go into it. 2015 has been, you know, traditional ramp down of the current model, and as we bring the new one online, but we are going to start to advertise this car consistent with the distribution strategy, and it's going to be heavy in California and follow other markets of demand. And as we cascade it out more nationally, there will be that support for this vehicle. It will be done within our Shattering Perceptions campaign. I'm going to actually show you a couple rough examples of a few of the pieces of communication that we'll have out in the marketplace. But it's really about getting people to reconsider and think differently about Chevrolet. There's a perception that people have about Chevrolet, and a lot of times we're in this industry, we're in this business, and we're seeing new cars all the time. We're behind the wheel of vehicles, and we're relatively current with our products and the competitors' products. But if you think about the average vehicle on the road, 11 years old, the average, you know, term of a loan, 5-6 years, people just aren't cycling through products as we are. And so when people get behind the wheel of today's Chevrolet, they're stunned at the technology, the innovation, the design, the materials, and the craftsmanship. And that's really the story that we're trying to tell. We're going to talk to owners because, again, we've got a lot of enthusiastic people out there, but we have a very specific conquest approach, as well as just people who are getting into the electrified space. There's more and more people, there's more and more acceptance of this technology, and we want to make sure we reach out to those people. The key messages are going to be the things that you see and what you experience in the tent here tonight, and what you will experience in the drive tomorrow. It's going to be design, it's going to be technology, it's going to be simple ways to remember those great statistics of 50, 53 miles pure EV, over 400 miles total range, and 1,000 miles between Phillips. And again, all the technology, whether it's infotainment, safety. And a big message for this car is the starting end price, $33,995, $1,200 less than the generation that's out there today. You know, and I always talk that, you know, this is a car, but it's a piece of technology. And a lot of times, technology is seen as something that has to progress. It has to get better. It has to get bigger or faster or process, whatever it is, whether it's a big screen TV or a phone. And it also has to be cheaper. It almost is, in a way, this vehicle kind of falls and straddles in that space, I think, between cars and just broader technology. So we're very proud of what we've done from a pricing standpoint. But one last thing is the success of Volt rides on a number of things, and one thing it rides on is making sure that our dealer network and public policy and the infrastructure is equally a part of our launch plan. And that's a big thing that we've been doing. So, you know, we were just with the EPA, NHTSA, and CARB 2 weeks ago. CARB's coming out here back to Detroit next week. And we talk a lot about what we're doing with our dealer partners, public policy, industry, to make sure that the environment more globally is ready for vehicles like this, and the technology and the infrastructure required to make these vehicles a success. So you're going to see a lot of advertising from us for this product as we move forward. Let me just show you a couple examples here. So these are our, what we call our experiments, or our films. So you've probably seen these, hopefully you've seen these, you know, in broadcast recently, or you may have seen them online. We've got Silverados with bears and cages. We've got people with, you know, keep your eyes on the road with distractions. We've got all sorts of work out there that is kind of provocative and interesting ways to get people just to talk about the Chevrolet product, and we reveal that Chevrolet product and get people just to get their honest reaction to it. So we have a couple examples here. So again, these are sneak peek kind of, you know, rough cut looks. We're actually going to be debuting a whole body of work starting tomorrow. So fourth quarter is always a big media quarter for us. So you're going to see the next wave of work. You'll see these two, but you'll see things with wood chippers. You're going to see egg tossing. You're going to see a lot more work behind all these great Chevrolet products talking about our technology. So I encourage you to go to YouTube tomorrow, because we have a homepage takeover. We'll have these films posted. But specific to Volt, we've got a couple here. The first one we call Time Capsule. And what it goes after is it's a nice little play here on the latest technology, because what people are always looking for is, I want to make sure that I'm buying the latest and the greatest. And we think we've got that in spades with this vehicle here. And we kind of think that maybe other vehicles out there might not have the latest technology. So